So let's talk about a fatty liver, specifically non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. The reason why I wanted to do this video is simply because 25% of the world population, I'm talking about adults, has this disease. In fact, 40% of the US population, talking about adults, has NAFLD. It's extremely, extremely common. But guess what? There's no symptoms in most cases. Now, there's two types of this disease. One type, you just have the fat only, and the other type is with the fat and the inflammation. Now, here's the problem with having a fatty liver. The symptoms don't occur right away. They take many years because the fat can then obstruct certain things in the liver, like the mitochondria, that then lead to inflammation, that then leads to insulin resistance, and then more insulin, more fat, and then scar tissue. So we go from a fatty liver to a fatty inflamed liver to cirrhosis, and then you need a liver transplant. Now, the problem with a fatty liver is the long-term effects and no symptoms until later. So you might not take action to change your diet until you have symptoms. Because a lot of people are walking around thinking, well, I have time, I'll just wait. It's not a problem. Everything shows up normal on blood test. And then one day they start seeing high liver enzymes and start having problems. And that's when they change. But by that time, it could be a little too late. Now, they are trying to change the name of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease to MAFLD, which stands for metabolic dysfunction associated with fatty liver disease. And the reason why they're trying to do that is this right here, metabolic dysfunction, which is really related to metabolic syndrome, syndrome X, where you have high blood pressure, high cholesterol, high blood glucose, central obesity, your fat right through here, which is exclusively caused by insulin. But let me just kind of give you a little bit more data about this. 90% of obese people have this right here. 60% of diabetics have this problem. And 20% of people with normal weight have this problem, with the majority having insulin resistance. So when you look this up and you do research, there's all this confusing information. It's all disconnected. It's not really aligned to an actual cause-effect relationship. In fact, one comment was, the mechanism of accumulation of triglycerides, that's the fat that's accumulating in the liver, is complex and incompletely understood. So this confusion only occurs if you don't know the definition, the functional definition of the word insulin. I mean, if you just take a look in any basic endocrinology textbook under the chapter of insulin, you'll quickly understand that insulin converts glucose to triglycerides. That's what's causing this. It's high levels of insulin. What causes a high level of insulin is carbohydrates, especially fructose, and omega-6 fatty acids. I'm talking about the vegetable oils, the soy oil, canola, corn oil, cottonseed oil. That can lead to insulin resistance and raise the insulin and create this problem as well. Now, if we take a look at non-alcoholic fatty liver disease and alcoholic fatty liver disease, two different causes, but same damage, same effect. So in other words, fructose and omega-6 fatty acids and other refined carbohydrates have a very similar effect to alcohol on the liver. You would think that alcohol creates the most damage, but not necessarily. Because this condition is so common, chances are some of you watching have this issue. And if you're new to my channel, it's very, very easy to reverse it. All you have to do is you have to understand the mechanism and get on the right eating plan. I put a link down below of exactly what you should do. And then, in 2 or 3 months from now, I would highly recommend going back, getting a reevaluation to see the change. All right, thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call, but I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.